Stimson. We're in Leoncy, in my garden shed actually. I do all kinds of crafts, but the main one I've always done is furniture making, and anything around furniture making and wood. It could be wood turning, carving. I also like painting, I do quite a lot of painting. I've done upholstery, but all crafts and painting. Basically anything with your hands and in arts and crafts generally. I like all forms of craft work, but particularly woodwork. Just the feel, I just feel I'm driven to it. After a certain length of time, when I haven't been doing anything for a while, I really get withdrawal. I feel I've just got to get back to it. I love wood. I love the grain, the unpredictability of the wood. I just like furniture. I go to exhibitions. I like seeing other people's furniture. Yeah, I just love wood. Well, I was always interested in craft work. I mean, I entered things in competitions. They used to call them Ice Steadfords when I was at school. Particularly models, model boats. But woodworking really was the thing which I enjoyed most of all. I did it in secondary school, and right from square one, I enjoyed it. I had an inspirational woodworking teacher who took me right the way up to O level, and I was then fixed on it. My father always made furniture. It was good, well, sort of semi-professional stuff. He was a carpenter, and he made stuff for the home. But he never had quite that finishing touch, and nothing professional. I suppose I was interested in it from then, but he never really inspired me. I had to give up woodwork before O levels. It clashed with other subjects that I had to do. But later, when I entered teaching, I did the timetabling for the subject that I was in, and I managed to get myself time off to do sitting guilds courses, short courses. I even did part of a degree in furniture design whilst I was working during another career. I suppose most of my training came in those early years at school, but really I am pretty well self-taught. I don't have any specific inspiration, but I always have to have a project on the go. I'm a bit of a wood junkie, and if I haven't got something going, I tend to get withdrawals. So once I feel something coming on, I really have to get started. It might be something I see, something we need for the home, something somebody else wants, but once I get started, I feel happy. Once I know what it's going to be that I'm going to make, I start off really with sketches, rough drawings, a lot of thought, ideas, lots of rough work. Finally, I draw up a plan. Then I usually make a small model. Sometimes I see things in shops. I make measurements from them. I just generally get ideas from different places, and then I get started. Making a piece of furniture is not really like painting. When you paint, you reach a point where if you don't stop, you can overdo it, and it ends up looking rather tight. Furniture making, generally speaking, the longer you spend, the more precise you are, the better it will be. And you only stop when you really feel yourself that there's nothing more you can do. It's very hard to give an average time on how long I spend on a piece. I mean, a pepper mill might take me a morning. Same with picture frames, I do those, probably complete one in the morning. I've spent much longer than that on things. A table and chairs I made for somebody once took me nearly a year. Probably the longest I've ever done are making rocking horses, where you've got to make the saddle, the leather parts, the bridles, and the stand for it to go on. That might take months at least. I once made a table and chairs for somebody, which took me almost a year to make. That was something like 14 chairs and quite a large table. So really, it can be anything from half a day to up to a year. The favourite piece, I think, is a piece that I made for my wife. It's a display cabinet, which we actually have in our home in the lounge. I particularly like it because it's made in the style of a carpenter who died in recent years, whose work I particularly like. My favourite tools, well, most of my favourite tools are old tools. They're beautifully made, and they're handmade, which you don't get with modern tools. I particularly like working with a plane that I've had for years, which is a Stanley smoothing plane. It works beautifully. The only thing it's got is a new blade. I've also got some good wooden spokeshaves that I like. You can't get those now, and they work much better than the new ones that you buy today, which are steel. Once I know what I'm going to make, the first thing I do is decide on the timber. I have to source that, and it's quite hard these days getting the quality of timber to make fine furniture. Then I make measurements and drawings. I work out a stock list from the drawings and the measurements. I machine the stock to the sizes that I think I'm going to want. and once that's done, I get started on the actual work of making the piece of furniture. Thank you.